Councilwoman Tasha Diaz. Oops, I'm sorry. Majority Leader, Councilwoman Tasha Diaz. Tasha, congratulations. You have proven to lots of people out there that even though you might be the underdog, you can accomplish, you can reach, you can exceed. Tell us, I know you're happy, but tell us how happy. What does this mean to you?
Well, it means a lot to me because I got the vote of the new city council president. That means a lot for her to come up to me and say, why is your name not in the race? Why are you doubting yourself? And I stood back and I looked and I said, she's coming to me saying, I believe in you. Why are you not believing in yourself? And I said, I looked back and I said, you know what? If I don't put my hat in the race, I can't blame anybody but myself if I don't get it. So with that being said, I threw my hat in the race. And when I threw my hat in the race, a lot of people said that I was strong-headed, that I would be the person to spearhead a lot of things, that I had a lot of good ideas to bring towards the council. And that's why they were in support of me. I got the majority of the Democratic caucus. I tried to work with my other two colleagues, but as stated, when someone has my word, they have my word, and I don't go back on my word. So I'm looking forward to working with my colleagues in all capacities collectively. It's a new year, new things. I'm still fairly a new council person, a majority leader, and I believe that God believes in me. My community believed in me, as well as my colleagues. So I'm just overjoyed.
Well, let me tell you, there is a reason I've been calling you the Iron Lady from the beginning.
You called it.
Right?
You called it. Yes, you did.
But look, Councilwoman, I heard the speech from the former Majority Leader and Councilwoman Shanine Williams. They were not pretty words.
No.
And I know that you are not the type of holding grudges about no one, but how do you feel about those words, and why do you think those words were said?
Those words were said because it was an attempt to tear me down, an attempt to take away the joy that I was going to receive today. Those words didn't bother me, really, because they weren't truthful, right? They say the truth hurts. As stated on a meeting, whatever they brought forth to the table, we can go to those people. We can have those conversations. Because I am a strong-headed person, they use the word curse out a lot, and I beg to differ. I use my words strong, like I stated, the squeaky wheel gets the grease.
That's your.
And I've been the squeaky wheel for everybody. And I just couldn't lie when it came to affordable housing to tell them that this would be your answer. They lied to them years ago and said that 10% was the answer, and it's not. And as my colleague stated, it's not that I didn't speak out on affordable housing. I did. But when I did, they didn't want to hear me because they kept stating that I was the new council person. But just because I'm new, that didn't mean that I didn't know what was going on. I knew what was going on, and I stayed true to my beliefs. And with that being said, now we're going to move forward with projects that they are all in agreement with, but it's the same projects that I brought to the table before we got this far. And they didn't want to agree on it because it was me. Like I said, I've always been a fighter. Nothing was ever handed to me. I was a mom at a young age. I've been married for 22 years. I've been with my husband for 24 years. People doubt me because of where I come from, but I can't change that. I was born there. I was raised there.
Well, you know, the attempt failed.
Yes.
You and I have spoken many times on Yonkers Voice about housing.
Yes.
You were very clear.
Yes.
You know, you explained exactly your position.
Yes.
Well, now you are the majority leader.
Yes.
Now let's get to work and make that happen.
Yes, yes. I'm ready to do new things. I'm ready for good things. I'm ready to move Yonkers forward. I'm just ready for everyone to come together. We lost so many people during Corona, and I just felt like my energy today to go back and forth with the women, it wouldn't be a good thing to do, right? Because that would show division. And as a majority leader, I don't want to divide. I want to bring everybody together so we can conquer.
Actions, not words.
Yes.
Let's move forward. Thank you, Councilwoman. Thank you, Majority Leader.
Thank you.